Welcome to Africa Business Report and Africa Business Radio, where we give you insights in business around Africa. I am Chukwunonso Modi. In West Africa, President Muhammadu Buhari will inaugurate the Lagos-Ibadan Standard Gauge project on June 10. The Minister of Information and Culture, Lai Mohammed, said during a joint inspection of the project with the Minister of Transportation, Mr. Rotimi Amaechi. The inspection was to ensure that all the T's are crossed and I's dotted ahead of the inauguration. The minister reiterated the commitment of the administration to improve the lives of people through the railway modernization projects across the country, which will significantly cut travel times and make traveling more comfortable. In Southern Africa, the latest Reserve Bank of Zimbabwe monthly economic report covering the period ending January 2021 has said foreign currency deposits held across the banking sector have increased to $108 billion under clear signs of prevailing economic stability has contributed to the upturn. It also shows a significant increase in US dollar deposits. During the period under review, local currency deposits also registered an annual growth of 384.11% in January 2021. While currency in circulation increased by 28%, merchandise imports eased by 12.7% from $527.2 million in December 2020 to $460.3 million in January 2021. In North Africa, 26 container and cargo ships have arrived at Damietta Port, Egypt over the past 24 hours. In a statement on Sunday, the Damietta Port Authority said the total trade volume of exported goods handled at the port reached 27,420 tons. It added that total trade volume of imported goods was 29,788 tons, it added. The statement also said 178,322 tons of grains are in the silos of the port, while wheat reserves in private warehouses reached 68,625 tons. In East Africa, pastoralist communities in northern Kenya have been asked to embrace use of biogas for cooking to reduce over-reliance on firewood that pollutes the environment and poses health hazards. Speaking during a tour of Masabit and Samburu countries to inspect a three-year project funded by the Swedish International Development Agency, Swedish Minister for International Cooperation, Per Olsen Fred, stressed the need for households to embrace the use of biogas energy as a way to mitigate effects of climate change. The cheap, eco-friendly energy ensures optimal use of animal dung and helps rid women and girls of the struggle of walking many kilometers to collect firewood, which remains a major source of energy for cooking in the region. You have listened to Africa Business Report and Africa Business Radio. You can continue to listen live online at www.africabusinessradio.com or via our mobile app. I am Chukwunonso Modi and thank you for listening.